Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to have an introduction to registers. In our previous classes, we have covered about synchronous counters, asynchronous counters, and all the different kinds of counters that are possible with synchronous and asynchronous. So, if you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos, because the counters are one of the applications of flip-flops. Flip-flops are used within the counters in order to count the numbers in a sequence. So the discussion about the counters has already been made in our previous video. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. Now coming to this class, we'll try to understand about registers. So one of the basic importance of flip-flop is to create memory elements. So the basic use of a flip-flop is to store one bit of value either 0 or 1 onto a device. So the use of the flip-flop is to create memory elements. So let's try to understand how the memory element can be created. So to increase the storage capacity, we can group the flip-flops. So what it means is, whenever we want to increase the storage value, storage capacity, we can group the flip-flops. What is the use of a flip-flop? A flip-flop can store one single bit. If you group a number of flip-flops onto one device, then we can store n number of bits. If you group n number of flip-flops, n number of bits can be stored onto a single device. So to increase the storage capacity, we can group the flip-flops. The device with a group of flip-flops is known as registers. Whenever we try to group the number of flip-flops onto one device, that device is what we call it as registers. Let's try to understand this point. To increase the storage capacity, we can group the flip-flops. So how it is going to increase the storage capacity? For example, if we take a D flip-flop, this is a D sample, simple D flip-flop. So we will take it in this way. So this is D's input and this is Q. So usually the flip-flops will be in this way. So far we have seen. So for simplicity, what we will do is, this is Q and Q bar. So Q and Q bar, this is D. So this is Q, not Q bar. So what we have done is, we have taken this D flip-flop in this way. So it is the input of the D flip-flop and this is the output Q of the D flip-flop. With one flip-flop, what we are going to achieve is, we can store one value, either 0 or 1. So it can be stored with either 0 or 1. Okay. So now with this, what is the value, what is the decimal number value that we can represent? We can represent either 0 or 1. If we combine the flip-flops, in the sense, if you take another flip-flop, so if you take two flip-flops, D, Q, so D1, D2, Q1, Q2, two flip-flops were taken. So now we are going to increase the storage capacity. Obviously, we can store another value onto this flip-flop. With that, what is the capacity that we can achieve? What are the values that we can store within this? This also is capable of storing either 0 or 1. So with 0 or 1, so how many number of values that we can store with these two flip-flops? It is 0, 0, 1, 10 and 11. So with this, with two flip-flops, we are going to store 4 values. It is capable of storing 4 values. To increase the storage capacity, if we want to increase the storage capacity, then we can group the flip-flops into one device, and that device is what we call it as resistor. Resistor is a storage device. So the entire RAM is made up of resistors. So the RAM, okay, so the resistor, as the number of resistors increases, it becomes n bit resistor. For example, if you have four flip-flops within a resistor, it is called as 4-bit resistors. So 4-bit resistor, 32-bit resistor, 64-bit resistors. So whenever we try to load the operating system onto, or any software onto the computer, it will ask whether your system is 64-bit or 32-bit, it will ask for. So what it means is, if it is 32-bit, It means that operating system is 32 bit means, so every value, every for example, if you take ASCII value, every character in the ASCII values are represented in 32 bits. Similarly, 62 bits means every character of the ASCII value will get represented in 64 bits. So that is what we call it as, that is what we call it as a resistor. Okay. So now, how the, what is the block diagram of the resistor is? So, and it is a common clock is provided to all the flip-flops. So how this flip-flop is designed is, so this is negative edge clock or positive edge clock, whatever it may be. So the each and every flip-flop is provided with common clock. It is same as that of synchronous clock. So synchronous device. So both are provided with the common clock, and whenever the clock becomes negative edge, whenever the clock is negative edge, so this is a negative edge triggered clock, which means that whenever we are in the negative edge, then only the values in the input will get stored onto the device. The values on the input, so for example, if you have 1 1 here, so in the first negative edge, this 1 1 will get stored onto this device, 1 1 will get stored, and immediately the output is going to change to 1 1. And in the another clock, if the numbers, if the inputs are 0 0 0 1, if the input is 0 0 1, now the input has been changed to 0 1, in the next negative edge these values will get stored onto this D flip flop. So I able to understand, so this is important point to understand. So 0 1 will get stored onto these two D flip flops and they will show as 0 1. Okay, so now the block diagram of the 4-bit resistor, for example, if you take a 4-bit resistor, generally we use D flip-flops because the input data flip-flop, the input whatever we give, that is going to be reflected onto the memory. So this is D flip-flop with 4-bit resistor, and we are having 4 D flip-flops. This is a D flip-flop and this is Q, D flip-flop Q output. And we are not going to represent this common clock. This common clock, the interconnection of the clocks will not be represented in the block diagram of a resistor. One single clock is provided, it may be negative edge triggered or positive edge trigger. Here we have taken negative edge trigger. So, but the interconnection of the flip-flops with the synchronous clock will not be shown in the block diagram, which itself means that the clock is connected to all the flip-flops. It does not mean that it is connected only to this D flip-flop. So the if we open it and see it is going to be in this way. So one single clock, but all the devices will get connected. So this is clock. Okay, so and these are the inputs and these are the outputs. But in the block diagram, it is going to be shown in this way. One single clock will be shown. It means that all the clocks are interconnected in this way. So this is very important point to understand. Okay. So whenever the clock is negative edge, it is going to take the inputs and those inputs will be reflected onto the output. So whenever the clock changes, if the input changes, those will get reflected onto the memory. So this is a 4-bit resistor with 4 flip-flops, and this is all about resistors. This is one of the a storage device that can be created by using flip-flops. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is very much helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.